Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Nizio Cole, and as we get closer to the release of Watch Dogs 3, I thought I'd ask Reddit what their thoughts and opinions and features that they wanted to be in the game, and I got actually quite a bit of responses, so I thought I'd just create a whole series on this, Ask Reddit. So I asked Reddit, what features do you guys want the most in Watch Dogs 3? And this is how they responded. Firefighter121 says, I think better law enforcement would be nice because we gotta admit that the cars weren't as nice as Watch Dogs 1, and the overall law enforcement experience of Watch Dogs 3 should be better, and I think that people should have police uniforms that they can put on in the game. Now, to answer your question, actually, there are police uniforms in Watch Dogs 2, or I think it's like one or two depending on what character you pick. And it comes in a DLC. I'll just put it up on screen if you guys are interested in that. And if you are in that police uniform, you actually unlock special dances and you get to arrest people. So that's pretty cool. But overall, yes, I do agree with what you're saying about better law enforcement. Most of the police in both games are pretty much just bots. Watch Dogs 1 police were really, really aggressive. But the Watch Dogs 2 police, I can't even... They're just not very intelligent, I guess you could say. Yeah, definitely need better AI, better, just situational awareness. I don't think police should be there for the sake of being there, but more just being there to add realism to the game. That's what I'm saying. Morrison says, more interactions with the world. I loved random conversations with pedestrians in Watch Dogs 2. Now that is something that's really interesting. I like the way the direction they went so that you could talk to people, you could dance and interact in Watch Dogs 2, but it felt kind of short. You know what I'm saying? You could have a conversation or you could start dancing and they'd be like, whoa, whoa. But like, it felt a little bit limited and like the key binds on console were just kind of weak, I guess you could say. Like you try and pull out something and then it was just overall an unfinished system that didn't really feel complete. And I would also appreciate that in Watch Dogs 3. Pure Ochre 1 says, what I would like personally is a proper story. There are some rumors about Watch Dogs 3 being an online game, having nice gameplay mechanics and graphics is nice, but it wouldn't make Watch Dogs the game it stands by without a well-planned, thought-out storyline. Aside from that, I really want Aiden back. Now, I know when the first Watch Dogs first came out, a lot of people, and I mean a lot of people, were hating on Aiden. And honestly, I really enjoyed his character, a classic revenge storyline. We've seen it a million times, but it was nice because it was a hacking game. It was interactive, and it kind of felt like Batman. I guess you could say playing as Batman. Aiden, there were some problems with this character, especially like... just the way he looked in general, but I think it was an overall, I'd grade him about a 7 out of 10. As far as the storyline bit, I do think we need a fully fleshed out storyline that we can just explore, and I think it'd be really interesting if we could do that, and I really hope that it's not an online all game. I do hope there's a campaign, and I'm guessing there'll be a campaign with rumors of it being in London, and I think that'd be just really, really interesting. And the last question that I'm going to be taking today is by KenV3. He says, more character personalization, more freedom in the settings, and proper driving mechanics. Now, I do think that the driving in Watch Dogs 2 was greatly, greatly improved versus Watch Dogs 1. There's not even any boost in Watch Dogs 1. Not that that's important, but it just... in Watch Dogs 2, I think if any of you guys have played, it feels like more... you have more control and there's different variety between vehicles. But I do agree that maybe... like a helicopter or a plane or something, some more exotic vehicles would be really nice. And character customization was at an all-time high in Watch Dogs 2. But I do think that it would be interesting maybe if there was a character creator so it didn't have to revolve around one character, but that would cause all types of problems in cutscenes, as you guys have probably seen before. Fallout 4, people create some crazy characters and they look absolutely ridiculous in cutscenes, and I don't know. I don't think that'd be the best thing for Watch Dogs 3, but it's definitely something for Ubisoft to think about. All right, now that was all the comments that I wanted to talk about in this video. I'm going to be making a follow-up video probably every week, uploading it on Saturday. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to drop a like down below, hit that notification bell, and yeah, see you guys later. Peace.